Hello, programmers. I have a new project for you. It is called Players on a Team. I start by analyzing the project definition, convert it into pseudocode, meaning fake code, then into actual Java code. We then need to test the program and document the project in a lab report. Here is the definition of the project. Different sports allow a different number of active players that are allowed on each team. For example, the NFL football allows 53. The NBA basketball allows 13. MLB baseball allows 25. And NHL hockey allows 23. Design a Java program that does the following. Determine whether a team has too few, too many, or just enough players. The program asks the user to select a team sport. Based on the user's selection, the program determines the number of players allowed on the team. The program then asks the user to enter the number of players trying to get on the team. If the number of players trying to get on the team is less than the number permitted on the team, the program will display, "There are not enough players." NN, more players are needed, where NN is the number of players needed. If the number of players trying to get on the team is greater than the number of players permitted, the program will display, "There are too many players," and players need to be eliminated. If the number of players trying to get on the team is equal to the number of players permitted, the program will display, "You have the correct number of players." Look at the samples of what the program could look like when running on the screen. The program displays a menu that gives the user the opportunity to select one of the sports, football, basketball, baseball, or hockey. In the first example, football is selected. The user's inputs are shown in blue in the video, but there won't be any colors shown when the actual program is running. The program says there should be 53 players and then asks how many players are currently on the team. If the user enters 60, the program responds that there are too many players and 7 need to be removed. Hockey is selected in the second example. 23 players are needed, but the user enters 21 for the number of current players. The program says there are not enough and 2 more are needed. In the third example, basketball is selected and the correct number of players is entered. There are 3 possible results for the program: too many, not enough, and just right. Word problems can get scary when you first look at them. Some of the information is just background information that we don't actually need to put in the program. Let's skip over the general description and get to the specifics. What we really need to do is first identify the program's inputs and outputs. Inputs: select a team sport. Another input: number of players trying to get on the team. There are only 2 things that the program needs to input. Now let's identify the outputs. Not enough players, more are needed. Too many players, eliminate 1. You have the correct number of players. This is the hierarchical input process output chart, also called a hypo chart. The first thing to enter are the inputs and the outputs. After the inputs and outputs have been entered, enter the processing needed to get from the inputs to the outputs. Going back to the project description, we can see all of the processing that needs to be done. The first thing the program needs to do is ask for the team selection and determine the number of players that should be on the team. The program then asks how many are on the team. After getting the user's input, the program needs to make one of the 3 choices: too many, not enough, or just right. The if, else if, else structure will be covered in more detail later, but for this program, the first if statement is checking for too few. If this is not the case, the program checks for too many using the else if statement. If too few, and too many both fail the test, the only thing left is just right, which is picked up by the final else statement. The typical format for a Java program starts out with the title block, the package statement, and any import statements that are needed. We then have the public class statement with its open curly brace. This is followed by the void main statement and its open curly brace. Then comes the list of variables, input, processing, and output. There are closed curly braces for each open curly brace. The braces identify a block of code or data. I am doing something extra for this program. I am placing the code that displays the menu asking for the selection of the sport in a separate piece of code. This is like having the boss telling one of the workers to go off and do a job and report the results back when the job is finished. Several different names in programming have been used to describe this separate piece of code: subroutine, subprogram, procedure, function, and method. A function is a type of subroutine that returns a value. For example, one of the math functions is named sqrt, which receives a number as its input and returns the square root of the number. When any of these become part of a class definition in object-oriented programming, it is referred to as a method or a member method. I am providing all of the code for this project as an image file. It is your job to type it in and make it work. The file is available on the Class Canvas webpage or can be located at http://program-info.net/java/downloads/java-players-on-team/java-players-on-team-code.png. You have to be careful and type in the capital letters where they're shown here. This slide shows the first page of the program with the package and import statements, the class definition, public static void main, and definition of the variables. One thing to notice is that this time the static scanner standard in is placed outside of void main to make it available to both the main routine and the select team size function. Here is the rest of the code for main. The first real executable code is for the program to call the select team size function, which is located at the bottom section of the code. I can tell that it is a function because it is returning a value that can be placed in the team size variable. The program displays the number of players that should be on the team and then asks how many are currently on the team. The processing section has the if, else if, else statements used to determine if there are enough, too many, or the correct number of players. It makes it much easier to write the code at this point because good names have been chosen for the variables. The if statement is asking if the number of players is less than the team size. If this test is true, the block of code identified by the open and closed curly braces is executed, so it computes the number of players needed and outputs a couple of messages to the display. When the if statement is true and its code is executed, the else if and else statements are skipped over. Since there is no more code after the block that belongs to else, we reach the end of main and the program ends. When the test for the if statement fails, the program tries to see if the else if condition will pass. It checks to see if the number of players is greater than the team size. If this is true, then the block of code attached to the else if is executed, which computes the number of extra players and displays an appropriate message. If this is true, then the block of code attached to the else if is executed, which computes the number of extra players and displays appropriate messages. The only time the else statement is executed is when all of the previous if and else if statements fail their test. This only happens in the players on team program when there are the correct number of players. Since there is no code after the if else we hit the end of main and the program ends. Look closely at the placement of the select team size function. It is placed within the open close curly braces for the class definition. This makes the function a member of the class. The function starts off with static int select team size open close parentheses. Let's not worry about the word static at the moment, but int in front of the function definition indicates that the function is going to be returning an integer back to the main program. The first thing that happens inside select team size is it displays a menu. It's called a menu because the list of options is displayed for the user, followed by a keyboard input to get the user's selection. Now we have a collection of if, else if, else statements that will select the team size based on the user's selection of the sport. The final else is used as the default condition that will display an error message if the user inputs an illegal selection. Actually, this program will crash if the user inputs anything besides an integer, a whole number. We could solve this by using the textbook author's text.io inputs instead of scanner for keyboard input. What comes next is the while statement. If you look at the closing curly brace just before while, you will see that its mating open curly brace is near the top of the function and part of the do open curly brace. This is part of the do while structure to keep the menu asking for a different value if we fall into the code for the else statement. The last thing that happens in the function is that it returns the team size back to the main program. The team size was determined by the if else if statements. I have only provided 4 team sports: football, basketball, baseball, and hockey. Go ahead and customize the program and pick different sports. There are a lot of them to go around. How about soccer, also is known as football to the rest of the world, or rugby, bowling, golf, synchronized swimming, or even Quidditch. This program should be a great learning experience in seeing how the if, else if, else, and do while structures can be used in a program, even though they have not been covered in detail yet. All you need to do is type the code in as shown and make the program work. From this point on, actual Java code instead of just an image of it will usually be provided. Sometimes I will provide only part of a program and you need to finish it. Other times, you will need to write the entire program on your own. And again, a great big welcome to the wonderful world of programming using the Java programming language.